Hello and welcome on what is a very rainy day here at Goodison Park on Merseyside. My name is Derek Ray, and with me for commentary is the former Arsenal and England fullback Lee Dixon. And very much looking forward to bringing you action from the Premier League. It is Everton up against Arsenal.
Yeah, thanks as always, Derek. It's a pleasure to be here. Anticipating a really good game today. The atmosphere is great. Certainly buzzing from the spectators' point of view as we head towards kick-off. Hopefully, we won't be disappointed.
Excellent vision. A matter of keeping his composure. An early goal. It is the ideal opening.
Top marks. Finishing at his best. Lovely through ball as well. The timing was perfect. Excellent finish.
And underway again, Arsenal other side in front. Jamal Lascelles. Ponce. Sigurdsson. Given away. So here's the table, and I think for West Ham United, you can say that it has gone against the grain of general expectations and not in a positive way.
Well, you have to look twice at the table to realise they're not in a Champions League place, and that's unthinkable, it really is. The club's in turmoil, way below the standards that have been set. Accountability, that's the key in any club, top to bottom.
Ponce, Poulsen. This could be an interesting avenue. Tremendous intuition to win it back. Well, I believe there's been a goal in the Liverpool game, Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Liverpool. 16 minutes played, 1-0.
And in with a real chance. Still a chance. And it's a double for him in this game. No way for the opposition to contain him. And no wonder he's off celebrating.
Well, let's see that again. Once he gets into his stride, he just strolls past players. What a lovely solo, wonderful effort this is.
Well, a second goal for them here. And he was in the right place to intercept. And Aubameyang in control. Real chance. Aubameyang! Priority was to hang on to the ball, which he did. Now with Aubameyang. And very deftly cut out. A strong play here on the shielding front. Lots of space for Arsenal. Great opportunity. Well, somehow the goalkeeper got to it. Over it comes. Into the goalkeeper's grateful grasp, but will it be? Gliding through the gears. Is this the moment? What a vital intervention. There's not a great margin for error when it comes to hitting it on the volley, Lee.
No, it's a really difficult technique, but it's worth a go. He had a go and he failed, but he'll get another chance.
And a goal has gone in the Liverpool match. Alan McAnally.
It's a second goal for Liverpool. It's been scored by Roberto Firmino.
Wonderfully weighted pass. Nketiah. Can they put it away? Almost what you might. That is top-notch goalkeeping. He had to reach in with his hand.
Yeah, it's all about reading the pace of the ball and the player's feet. When do I go down? When do I strip the ball? Did a brilliant job then. Well, Derek, the floodgates are open. How many goals are they going to score? They've created so many chances. If they put half of them away, it could be a cricket score.
Koulibaly. Poor attempt at a pass, really. Nketiah. Now with Aubameyang. Guendouzi, is it going to be? Still possibilities. Poulsen,
Wow, listen, that crowd, they're trying to get their team back in it. If that would have gone in, you feel it would have been over.
There's plenty of know-how in the ball shielding department.
This official has indicated
Tom Davis.
It will be now.
Making progress. Read it magnificently and intercepted. And the managers will now deliver their half-time team talks. The two teams have switched around and are ready now for the second half.
To be replaced by number five, Michael Keane.
Nicolas Pepe. I must say, this looks promising. Poulsen. And Sigurdsson with it. I can tell you, a goal has been scored at Old Trafford. Who has scored that goal? Alan McInally.
It's a second goal for Manchester United. 50 minutes, please. 2-1.
Thank you, Alan McInally. End product or not. Has a go. Well, it's a procession of goals. And surely there's no way they can let this slip now. Absolutely dominant.
Well, look at this. Don't you just love counter-attack football? Absolutely brilliant. One key ingredient, pace. And they've got it in abundance. What they do to that defence from then on is absolutely brilliant.
Well, it's been such a one-sided game. You just wonder how many more they could add. And it's Tom Davis. He will be. And move it. Can he put it away? Now, counter-attacking possibilities here. Good technique displayed. Still looking for space. And thwarting his opponent in the nick of time. A goal has gone in at Molineux. Let's hear more about it from Alan McInally.
It's a goal for Wolverhampton Wanderers. 62 minutes played. 2-1.
Thanks, Alan. Jemerson now. Koulibaly. Tom Davis. Can he take advantage? And the goalkeeper, Lee, a picture of concentration.
Well, he had his eye on the ball, he waited for the striker, and then he smothered it. It's really, really good goalkeeping.
The end product just wasn't there. Kieran Tierney. It's a weighted pass, and now waiting to pounce. The net is staring him in the face. And that completes an impressive hat-trick.
Well, keep counting. Three now. But at this rate, he's in for a hatful. Well, here's the replay. You have to say he's been a thorn in the side of the opposition all match. It's a good finish and a richly deserved hat-trick.
Substitution time it is. Well, we're underway again, and this game was finished as a contest a long time ago. My goodness, he was right on top of the situation to get the ball back for his team. Breaking at pace. Real chance. Might still be able to do a bit of damage. Just not looking confident in possession. Advantage, Arsenal. Thunders clear. Antonio. Ponce. He will be. Oh, a fine block. Often tempting to blow your whistle straight away, but the referee let it flow and then went back and handed out the yellow card.
Well, he thought he got away with it, hadn't he? He looked over his shoulder, then all of a sudden the referee's there with a yellow card.
Nicolas Pepe. 10 minutes left for play in this match. Really good reading of the game to win possession back. Just been a thoroughly cogent and convincing performance in this match, Lee.
Creating it.
Oh, surely. And there it is. A goal. But will it be purely a consolation at this stage of the proceedings? They haven't been at their best.
Everton goal.
Goals in plentiful supply. 4-1 currently. On and on he goes. Well, that would be straightforward for any keeper. Torreira moving the ball forward with purpose. Fruitful looking attack. Thumped clear. And firing it into the area. Not a strong glove on the ball from the keeper.
2 minutes of added time.
Guendouzi. Torreira. Well, that's how to break the spirit of the attacker. And there goes the final whistle. Well, his performance.
Just a moment of your time. That'll be all.
And it all comes rushing back. I've been making up my mind. I never opened up, took it all in, and now I'm running out of time. Sometimes I dream about going back, keeping all the things I left behind. But now I know you can't change the past, way too young to know.
Our main feature today on EA TV, two great clubs. It's coming up for you live. Here we are today at Old Trafford. Manchester United have had so much success down the generations. Martin Tyler here along with Alan Smith. We have Premier League action for you coming right up. Manchester United against Arsenal.
I love visiting this ground. Rarely been disappointed with the entertainment on offer. Don't think I will be today either.
They've shuffled their pack today, Manchester United. David De Gea starts in goal. Sead Kolasinac starts, looking to continue his good form at the back. Iago Aspas is the main striker today. Terrific tackle. I don't think there's any doubt now that we're going to have a fight to the finish here. A really exciting end to the season.
I think any neutral loves to see it. I mean, it's nerve-shredding for the teams involved. You can't make a mistake at this stage because it might just cost you dearly.
Oh, the lead is here for the taking. And there it is for Arsenal.
We just feel sorry for the keeper, really, the way he's hit that to his right. He's got no chance of getting a hand on it.
Arsenal with the lead. Alan McInally with a goal to tell us about from Aston Villa's game.
It's a goal for Manchester City. 14 minutes played, 1-0.
Thanks, Alan. Well, we'll follow that with interest. Successful tackle. Nathan Ake. He might have put his teammate in here. Good interception. Now Martin Odegaard. Made a quick interception. Now there is some space in the wide area. There's still danger here after this half clearance. Marcel Sabitzer. Well, let's hear from Alan McInally. We've got a goal to tell us about at the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium.
It's a goal for Liverpool. 23 minutes, please. 1-0.
Great to have Alan McInally out and about for us. And he's brought us right up to date again there. And in it goes. It was a promising situation. They could have made more of that. Referee's done extremely well to judge it like that. He can play the advantage. Real opening now. It's in. Fine moment for them. They've got a firmer grip on the game now. They're two ahead. Well, two against the goalkeeper, and they managed to stay onside and worked it perfectly, really.
Yeah, they did, and players of this standard should be able to work it perfectly. And the pass was released at just the right moment, taking the keeper out of the equation.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. At Villa Park for us today, Alan McInally with news of a goal.
It's a second goal for Manchester City. It's been scored by Paulo Dybala. There must have been 40 passes leading up to this one. At the end of it, he was left with a simple tap-in. 32 minutes played, 2-0.
Top work, Alan. We're back here now with Alan Smith.
United, as you can see, got a firm grip on possession, but they've just not been good enough going forward. I think what they've worked on in the week, the manager was talking about, they haven't really put it into practice out there.
It's a good hit. Well, that's a great block. Now Lucas Torreira. Jerome Roussillon. Going forward well. Opportunity to play it into the middle. Takes the shot off. Very good piece of work by the goalkeeper to turn that away from danger. Aspas. Now Martin Odegaard. Well, the signal's gone up for 2 minutes.
There will be a minimum of 2 minutes of added time.
Aspas. That's a great interception. Half time now, and 2-0 is the score at the break. And it's Arsenal who hold the advantage as the second half is underway. And that's broken up by the defender before the cross could come in. Delaney. Now Martin Odegaard. Aspas. Alan McAnally is our man at Tottenham Hotspur today with news of a goal in that match. This could be an opportunity in behind the defence. There was a chance, really, of getting into a scoring position then, but anything but. Roussillon. Well, we did interrupt Alan McAnally earlier. Not an easy thing to do, I can tell you, but he did tell us that Liverpool scored in that match. The score is now 2-0. Marcel Sabitzer.
Well, a real treat in store for you. Coverage on EA Sports of the Premier League fixture
for Manchester United. They'll be facing Brighton and Hove Albion.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Now, can they make this count? Keeping the ball well in a dangerous area now. And that's a penalty for Manchester United. The penalty, I think it was clear-cut, and the fact that the referee's not booked anyone, is that a bit lenient?
Maybe, but on the plus side, I think he's showing a bit of common sense. The penalty, I feel, is...
too high! Oh, what a waste!
Well, we say it so often, always leaning back on that one.
Alan, what about Arsenal's next game?
Yeah, they're playing Chelsea in their next match. I think it's going to be pretty easy for them.
Oh, the striker stopped there as they broke away. Good defending. Alan McAnally is at the Tottenham Hotspur Stadium today and he's got news of a goal.
It's a third goal for Liverpool. 62 minutes played, 3-0.
Thanks, Alan. Well, we'll follow that with interest. Threads it through. Hasn't held it, the goalkeeper. West Ham United have made their move in the transfer market and they've signed their man.
Well, about 20 million quid, we read, and if that's so, I think they've got a bargain. Well, they've grabbed hold of this match. Got a bit of work to do to get back into it, but certainly heading in the right direction. The fans realise that, they're acknowledging it.
And the ball's got away from it.
Yeah, Arsenal not having as much of the ball as normal. But what you would say about this team is the way that they've used the possession so ruthlessly at times. It's been a joy to watch, textbook stuff from them.
Aaron Wan-Bissaka. So we're coming down now towards the last 15 minutes. Trying to find the opening, which would be so crucial. Good width in the attack here, looking for a cross at the end of it. Another turnover in play here with that interception. Well, the wide man can show his skills here. now they're looking to get forward from this position. Marcel Sabitzer. In quickly. Five more minutes here. And he's confident with the ball at his feet, isn't he?
Is he in here? Well, now it looks like a question of just how many. They really are on top now, stretching the lead, looking like the real winners of this match. And that's the goal then for Arsenal.
The defenders seem to lose the concentration almost. They saw it coming from a long way out.
Little surprising that it is as one-sided as this late in the game, but the team leading deserve the margin of what's going to be a very comfortable victory. Delaney.
We've got
2 added minutes.
There will be a minimum
Rashford.
2 minutes.
Now Martin Odegaard. And that's dealt with easily by Leno. That is the final whistle.
Hi, just a couple of questions for you. Thanks for the questions.
Where should I begin?
Right, feeling like a brand new me and an entourage with a latest beat and a